Allahu Akbar.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salamu ala ashrafil mursaleen Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man tabi'ahum bi ihsan ila yawmiddin. Sometimes it's difficult to talk after all of this eloquent, very well articulated speakers and everything we have learned over the last 2+ days. However, it's great to remind myself and my brothers and sisters with a few things. First, I would like Dr. Zahid Bukhari yesterday was talking about the outstanding job that our sisters in ICNA have been doing, and their effort have succeeded every expectation, and they have done a lot more than our brothers have done in every aspect. So in this regard, I would like to say Jazakumullah khairan. And it is not just in ICNA, it is the same situation in MASS. And if you see any Muslim convention, you can realize that the participation and the effort of our sisters is a lot more than our brothers. So Jazakumullah khairan for being who you are. SubhanAllah, we have been talking about the Sharia and the education and the development and the challenges that we have been facing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have told us a very profound statement in a verse of the Quran when he told us, وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوْا. Don't feel sad or weak because you are the highest. In spite of everything around you, you are the highest. وَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ وَلِلْرَسُولِهِ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Indeed, izzah, dignity, honor, respect, pride belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His Messenger, and the believers. And as long as we are working together and we are keeping the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, living Islam in our life, as a true believers, we have that. We have the izzah, we have the honor, the respect, the dignity, and the pride, and no human being on the face of the earth can take that away from us. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, وَأَنَّ الْأَرْضَ لِلَّهِ يُورِثُهَا مَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ. Land, earth belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it belongs to the Creator. And basically our job as a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as a believer, is to live Islam, deliver His message, and get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by serving His creation, by carrying the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and providing a real service to everyone around us. Whether we have immigrated over here 3 years ago or 300 years ago, we are citizens of this land, and it is our duty and our job to stand up for what's right and to stand up against whatever is wrong. It is our job, it is our duty, it is what we have to do. Brothers and sisters, when we live over here for the sake of our country, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Creator, let us make sure that every one of us will register to vote, and that's not enough. We'll make sure that our families, our neighbors, and we will have a very serious campaign that everyone, whether it's Muslim person who have decency, who have heart and conscience, is registering to vote and is participating to shape our future. the future of this country, and we cannot afford not to do that. It's an Islamic duty. ICNA, MASS, all of our Islamic institutes, we are in the business, as Dr. Zahid mentioned, of developing people, personal development. 44 years ago, plus a few more months, I attended my first well-organized, structured study group, Islamic study group. And after 2 hours of reading, reciting Quran, and learning, the leader of this group told me, or told all of us, by the way, over the upcoming week, I would like each one of you to go ahead and teach 10 people whatever you have learned tonight. That's your job, to deliver this message or whatever you have learned tonight to 10 people, and when you come back, you need to report that and what kind of education or knowledge you have delivered and what did you learn. We don't learn for the sake of knowledge. We learn in order to develop ourselves, to live Islam and deliver the message, convey the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to everyone around us. This is our job. This is a true personal development, is to learn, to teach, to live Islam as a real believer and true believer. And please, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, إِنَّمَا يَأْكُلُ الْغَنَمُ الْأَزِئْبُ مِنَ الْغَنَمِ الْقَاسِيَةِ. You cannot do that on your own, by yourself. You have to belong. You have to belong to the Muslim community. You have to be within an organization. You have to do it within organized, structured work in order to be able to achieve and reach out to everyone around you. Together, we can do it, inshallah, Rabbi Ameen. Alone, we will never be able to succeed. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward every and each one of you, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all of the efforts. Jazakumullah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.